It only took me 28 years to do this for the first time myself. When I got into the kitchen, she dropped an absolute reality bomb on me. Obviously, I had to let go of a couple of friends who didn't.
Reminiscing on the past, where I moved from the Balkan to the Netherlands as a refugee and then decided to leave everything in Amsterdam again to move to India, made me realize how some of my biggest mistakes in life...
No. I'm shaking. This was crazy.
...have taught me the best lessons.
I am on that one-way road of dreams to India.
Not only did I switch countries, but I also switched a corporate career for my own business featuring lots of travel. In this video, I'm discussing those biggest mistakes I made in life so you know what to avoid in order to create your best life. The top 5 biggest mistakes I'm going to discuss are 1. Not making a bucket list. 2. Not questioning the reality you're born in. 3. Not putting yourself on number 1. 4. Not minding your company. And number 5. Judging people for the color of their skin.
Biggest mistake number 1, and it only took me 28 years to figure this out, not making a bucket list. Did you know that if you write something down, a goal or a result that you want to achieve, the chances of you achieving it increase with 42% by just writing it down? That's right. Like I said, it also took me 28 years to make a bucket list for the first time ever in my life. The question that I asked myself when making my bucket list was, what are all the things that I would regret not doing before I die? One of those things that may seem extremely trivial to anybody else, but it was important to me, was getting a Chanel bag. It was something that I had always dreamed of, even as a little girl, so it was important for me to write that down. A couple of years later, when I got an unexpected tax return, which was massive, and I didn't have any plans with that money, I saw that Chanel bag on my bucket list and I knew, okay, I have to do it now. If I'm being very honest, I don't think I would have had the courage to buy such an incredibly expensive bag if I wouldn't have written it down on my bucket list and reminded myself that it was something that I had always wanted, even as a little girl. For other people, it may have been a car. For me, it was a Chanel bag, and hence I bought my Chanel bag. Another bucket list item that I realized just by writing it down was sitting in the harbor of Hong Kong, having a Subway sandwich with enough money in my bank account to travel in Asia for 6 months. It was a dream that seemed absolutely impossible when I wrote it down, but a few years along the line, I made it happen, and I know 100% it was because I had just written it down.
This is something I do every single time I come to Hong Kong. I just return to the harbor, I get a Subway sandwich, and it's just my little honoring ritual for the Ivana of the past who made this dream true.
So if there's just one takeaway from this video that you implement in your life, I would love for you to make a bucket list because it absolutely changed my life. It will be the most joyful, fun 10-20 minutes that you spend today writing down what you want to accomplish in your life. Biggest mistake number 2, never questioning the reality that you were born in. Again, it only took me 28 years to do this for the first time myself. The reason is that we are born in a certain reality that our parents create for us. And the best description that I have read about how reality is created is from the book, The Rule of Law. 1010 can recommend that book. It is absolutely amazing. He describes that if a man and a woman from two completely different worlds end up on a deserted island, even though they are from different cultures and they may speak different languages, they will start to develop their own language and their own rituals. Now, if a baby is born on that deserted island, that baby will not know anything else than that bubble of reality, right? His parents know different realities, but that baby doesn't know any other reality. This was actually the case for me and probably a lot of other people with me as well, because I was raised according to the very old traditional blueprint. You get a diploma, you find a good job, you buy a house, you get married, and you have children. That was it. That was my whole life plan because that's how I was raised. I never questioned my own reality until one day while I was working at my corporate job, just sitting behind my boring desk in suburbia Amsterdam. I was 28 years old when one of my best friends now, Claudia, came up to me. I was working with her and told me, come to the kitchen right now. I have something extremely excited to tell you. Claudia and me had ticked all the first three boxes. So I thought she must be pregnant or getting married, one of those two. When I got into the kitchen, she dropped an absolute reality bomb on me by saying, I am going to travel the world for a year with my boyfriend. And I was like, what? You can do that? Claudia proved to me that there are different realities in life and you have to see what you want to accomplish in life, because there are many, many different ways that a person can live their life and become happy. So from that moment on, I started looking into options for me to travel, for even having a career in travel, for maybe even having an alternative career to my corporate career. Claudia completely changed my life by that one alternative reality decision that she made in that moment and she decided to share with me. Nowadays, you don't even have to have your own Claudia. Social media, and especially YouTube, gives you the opportunity to get a glimpse of other people's lives and hence different realities. So I would then recommend you to look outside of your reality bubble and see what else is out there. How are other people living their life and what would that mean for your own reality? Are you actually happy in your own reality, or are you living it because that's the reality bubble that you were raised in? YouTube is a very good starting point. There are so many different and diverse people on this platform. So just look outside of your bubble and see what else is out there. Biggest mistake in life, number three, not putting yourself first. This is something that I had to learn the hard way, because I was always a person who would, you know, put my own needs second. If a best friend wanted to do something, I would be like, okay, let's do what you want, because I thought that would make her love me more. Or if an ex-boyfriend of mine wanted to do something else with, for instance, our house, I would be like, okay, let's do that, because, you know, if we do that, then you may love me more. But honestly, this is such a sure way to burn yourself out, because there's only one person who can fulfill your needs and who knows exactly what you need to be happy in life. I was very lucky that my ex-boyfriend, in the beginning of our relationship, sat me down when he saw that I was doing these things for him. He literally told me, put yourself first, go out there, make yourself happy. And if you're happy, that makes me happy. So from that moment, I started doing that more and more. And I also realized that my true friends who really love me, obviously I had to let go of a couple of friends who didn't, they actually turned out to be more happy with me putting myself on number one and fulfilling my own needs, because that meant that I was a much more happier person around them, and I could also now fulfill their needs better because my needs were already fulfilled. It is really true what they say in the airline safety instructions: put your own oxygen mask first and then take care of other people, because that way you will be able to give them a lot more. Which brings me to biggest mistake number four, not minding your company. And I don't mean company as in business, I mean company, the social circle that you surround yourself with. We humans are social creatures. We are wired to be tribal. So the people who you surround yourself with will 100% have an impact on the way you think, the way you feel, and the things that you are going to accomplish in life. Like I mentioned before, me putting myself on number one led some people around me to be extremely unhappy, and it made me realize that they really didn't care that much about me. So it was time for me to let those people go. It also meant that I had to take a massive distance from certain family members who were making me very unhappy because they were unhappy. They were very incapable of being happy up to the level that I am capable of. So every time I would be twice as happy as them, they would try to bring me down, because again, we're wired to be tribal, right? So you want the people around you to be in your zone. For me, it meant that I had to create a massive distance in order to maintain my own happiness. This definitely doesn't mean that you always have to let go of people. Like I said, you can also just create a distance, which is a lot more effective, especially if people are family or if you have known those friends for decades. A little bit of distance can also mean a lot more space for yourself to fulfill your dreams, to be as happy as you want, and to realize the results that you want. The people who do support you and who are on that same level as you, you should keep them as close as possible, because like I said, Claudia and my ex were definitely the people who were responsible for me evolving into a happier, more fulfilled human being. Biggest mistake number 5, judging people based on the color of their skin. I'm going to talk about Black Lives Matter because my best friend Nadine is a Black woman, and she is literally the most beautiful human being I have met in my life, and definitely always my mentor on what is right and what is wrong.
No. If we're gonna do this, we have to do this responsibly.
Yeah.
And we have to read up on it and stuff like that, yeah, before we end up on a volcano with no gas. And dizzy children and a dizzy Nadine.
Yes.
We don't even know the altitude of Etna.
No.
So, we were so unprepared.
Yeah. It's not a good idea, guys.
I met Nadine when I was about, I think, 9 or 10 years old. I had just moved to the Netherlands as a refugee. I was actually born in the Balkan, but because of the war, we had to go to the Netherlands, my parents and my brother and me. Starting out in a new class, Nadine and her best friend decided that they would start bullying me because they thought that I was copying Nadine's style of clothes. But after 1 week, Nadine felt really, really bad about it. And instead of bullying me, she and her best friend decided to adopt me as their best friend. Now, you have to know something about me being raised in a Balkan country. I had never seen a Black person before because there are not that many Black people in the Balkan. This was the first time and the first interaction that I had with Black people. For Nadine, however, racism was already a reality that she was dealing with as a very young child. She had a Dutch friend, a white girl, who would close the curtains in her house because the neighbors were not supposed to see her playing with a Black girl. One time she was chosen to be Zwarte Piet in the whole Sinterklaas traditional celebration in the Netherlands, and the teacher made a joke about Nadine not having to paint her face because she was already Black. It would have been so easy for Nadine to hate me, a white girl, because of how white people had already treated her early on in her life. Instead, she chose to adopt me as her sister, because by now we have been best friends and sisters for more than 2 decades. In those 2 decades, every single time that I would maybe even have a thought of judging people, maybe a little bit on their skin color or their religion or their financial background, it was always Nadine who taught me that no, that is stupid. You shouldn't judge people by the color of their skin or their religion or their financial background, because each person is an individual and they all have their unique skills and capacities for what they want to achieve in life, but also how they want to treat other people in life. Nadine single-handedly is responsible for me treading into the world, meeting people from so many different cultures and in so many different countries, expecting the best of them. That is truly something that Nadine has taught me, and learning how she experienced racism and how she still is overcoming that, because she has a beautiful car but she still gets pulled over by the police just because of the color of her skin. It teaches me that we can overcome this. If she can be that beautiful person who doesn't judge people based on the color of their skin, who adopted me, a white girl, as her sister, then we can do better too. We white people can do better too. We can learn from Black people and their tolerance and learn how to accept people for who they are and not judge them based on the color of their skin. Being here in India is possible because of what Nadine taught me. I came here with an open mind, with a lot of respect for Indian culture, especially also looking back at the history that India has with colonialism. And I have been met, for the majority, with the greatest kindness and patience and generosity, which is something that I am now also again learning from people with with a different skin color than me. It's absolutely mind-boggling what you can learn if you just open up your mind. So I am extremely grateful to Nadine for teaching me this, for being my mentor in life. If you would like to learn more about Black lives and Black people, I have linked some incredibly inspiring TED Talks, some of my favorites, down in the description below. A better world truly starts with yourself and with your actions. I really want to hear your thoughts on this topic as well, so please share them down in the comments below. Also, make sure to put a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video and if you would maybe like me to make a part two. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, make sure to click that subscribe button, click the bell icon to get the notifications whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!